Corinthians 13, 11.
Tasoma pia Korinto wa kwanza 13 kifungu cha 11.
And I'll read Proverbs 1.
Tasoma pia Methali 1:5.
Praise God so much.
Bwana asifiwe sana.
That's what you are going to read today.
Hiyo ndio tutakuwa tunasoma siku ya leo.
But I want to talk about searching for the meat.
Nataka kuzungumza kuhusiana na kutafuta nyama.
Praise God.
Bwana asifiwe.
Not meat that we go to the supermarket or to the shops.
Si nyama tunayoenda kwenye bucha ama kule madukani kutafuta.
But searching for the spiritual meat.
Lakini ni kutafuta nyama ambayo ni ya kiroho.
Praise God so much.
Bwana asifiwe sana.
Searching for the spiritual meat.
Kutafuta nyama ambayo ni ya kiroho.
In 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 2.
Katika Petro wa kwanza sura iko ni ya pili kifungu ni cha pili.
Bible says.
Biblia inasema.
And young like a newborn infant.
Kama vile watoto wachanga.
And young as infant newborn babies.
Kama vile watoto wachanga.
For the pure spiritual milk.
Wanayotamani maziwa.
So that by it you may grow up to salvation.
Ili katika hayo ukaweze kukua katika hali ya kiroho.
Praise God.
Bwana asifiwe.
First Corinthians 13.
Wakorintho wa kwanza 13.
11.
11.
Bible says.
Biblia inasema.
When I was a child, I talked like a child.
Wakati nilipokuwa mtoto nilinena kama mtoto.
I thought like a child.
Nilifikiri kama mtoto.
I reasoned like a child.
Nilifikiri kama vile mtoto.
But when I became an adult.
Lakini nilipokuwa mtu mkomavu.
I set aside childish ways.
Nikauteka ule ambao ni mtoto.
Praise God so much.
Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
Amen.
But how did it?
Lakini muktadha wetu
is Proverbs.
Ni Methali.
Open Proverbs.
Fungua Methali.
Praise God so much.
Bwana asifiwe sana.
Proverbs chapter 1.
Methali,
chapter 2. Just chapter 2.
Methali sura ikiwa ni ya pili.
Verse 1 to verse 5. Praise God.
Bwana asifiwe.
Stand there. Just be there, be in Proverbs, don't move out.
So
we have read from the book of Peter.
Mwanzo tumesoma katika kitabu cha Petero.
And it's telling us that as newborn babies, we should yearn for milk.
Na inatuambia kwamba kama vile watoto wachanga ni lazima tuwe na tamanio ambalo ni la maziwa.
So that we may grow in salvation.
Ili kwamba tukaweze kukua katika wokovu.
We may grow up to salvation.
Tukaweze kukua hadi kwenye wokovu.
I word.
Sure.
Because you are with God. Praise God so much. You must accept the word and interpret it into your life and spirit. You need to put it in your heart and keep it there forever and ever. But what you should not do is to change the word to agree with your way of life, of living.
Repent.
teaching the word of God.
Kufundisha katika neno la Mungu.
That you should not lack anything.
Kwamba usikose chochote.
Right.
Katika maisha.
Praise God, church.
Bwana sifiwe kanisa.
Four.
Jambo la nne.
Guarding your heart to the heart to understand it.
Ukaweke katika moyo wako ili kwamba uweze kuielewa.
Need to turn your heart in order to understand the word of God.
Kama dhabihu na kuweze kuitafuta kama kitu ambacho kimefichika.
then this is what will happen.
Basi ni hiki ndicho kitafanyika.
Then you understand the fear of the Lord.
Basi utaelewa ile hofu ya Mungu.
Once you do all those four steps I've given
you, unapofanya mambo yale yote manne ambayo
nimekupatia,
utaweza kuelewa.
Praise God.
Amen.
Understanding the fear of God.
Elewa hofu ya Mungu.
What does the word of God say?
Neno la Mungu linaniambia.
Honor the Sabbath.
Ukaweze kuiheshimu Sabato.
And keep it holy.
Na kuiweka kuwa takatifu.
And the same Bible says.
Na pia ile ile Biblia inasema.
Do not need to come together to fellowship.
Weaker.
Kuwika mara? Otapo medikana mara? Uyu jamaa alikuwa na vitendo vya uongo. Uyu jamaa anambia huyu ni mola. Wewe. Umekosa tu hii ni roga identity bwana. Mbadilia pia mola na wewe. Anasema huyu jamaa mzee mtu hii. Anaenda wale wengine. Si huyu pia ni mola. Kumaliza kuka. Jamaa Yesu akamwangalia. Kama unaona hiyo mtu sasa akamwangalia. Ijamaa kikitoka mbio, ilikimbia mbio, ikaingia sawa ikaanza kulia. Yesu alisamehe, nimefanya makosa. Alijua makosa yake. Alijua. So pia sisi, mtu akikwambia hapa, uko na shida. Kama uko nayo, tubu. Kama hakuna, sio wajane na huko. Praise God. Very simple.
Rahisi tu.
Yes. I want to tell you, Jesus loves you.
Yes, you
and when you seek the knowledge of God, you'll be able to chew that meat. You'll be able to go through the hardship, the difficult times. Amen.
Amen.
So may God bless you
for
that. Why?
As you
begin to admit. Let's bow our heads and we pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you and bless you for this time. You have been faithful in our lives. You kept us well. You talked to us about chewing meat and searching for meat so that you may live to drink milk, because we are no longer children. Father, teach us more and more about how we can walk in chewing meat. For the offerings and
the offerings.
Those who have given your house. And those who are still giving. Those who don't have. Provide that you may have. Thank you.
Asante.
For the meeting that you're going to have. Speak with us. Talk in us. Let peace be there and happen. That you may speak in love. For glory of your name. In Jesus' name. Amen. Those who are still giving, chance is still there. You can still
give.
And may God bless you. Praise God so much. Those who have brought Mavuno, please, can you bring it and you may pray for it? May God bless you. Amen. Can you help? If one is far, it is very heavy, you will just tell us, we shall pray from there.
Where it is.
Someone will tell us who has brought and we shall
pray.
Amen. You see, now we are moving. The Bible says, let my house have food. Amen. Yeah, this is a big step. Can you clap for that? I have also one bag in the house. This is Mavuno also. The other and also one bag, 90 kilograms. Can you clap for that? Still bring those who have Mavuno, still bring the house of God. When you have food like that, when you have a conference, we don't have a budget. So may God bless you.
Mungu awabariki.
Let's pray for the first fruit. Father, I thank you for the first fruit that has been brought to your house. I ask you to bless those hands that I've given. You said in your word that you blame the devourer. When we test you with a little, see, we have brought that in your house. And we ask you to blame that devourer who is going to devour our fruits, our crops. In our homes. And we ask you, my Father, that you may see our farms when we plant next year. Bless that we may have enough because of what you have brought in your house. Bless the hands that have brought. Bless the families that has brought. Their children should serve blessing. Their business should serve blessing. Their farms should see a blessing. Father, we thank you because of them. And those who are planning to bring, touch their hearts in order that they can bring. Thank you because you have done. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Bless you. I don't have any announcements, but please don't go. Let us have this meeting for 1.5 hours. So tomorrow say Saturday. Praise God. Amen.